Second episode.
Yeah.
We are reverse searing steaks today. Well, a steak.
A cowboy ribeye. I got it from Patton's Meat Market in Duluth, my favorite spot to go. If you live in the Atlanta area, go there. It's awesome. Yeah, what's I did the, pay $25 for one steak.
Oh, my God.
But it's a good steak, though.
Better be a good steak.
It's like a pound and a half.
Also, it's like 94 degrees out here right now. It's so hot.
Good news is we can do all of this really quick.
Yeah. This doesn't take very long.
So what we're going to do is we're going to grill it at a low temperature over indirect heat. We're going to be grilling at about 260, 275. We're going to grill it for probably about 20 minutes. And then we're going to take it off and we're going to sear it at the end. So the idea here is that when you reverse sear something, you cook it at a low temperature first so that you get a really even color all the way through the steak. So it won't be just super pink in the middle. It'll be pink all the way throughout. And we're going to sear it at the end just to get a good crust on it.
Oh, is this the same guy as last time?
Yeah, same guy as last. This is my favorite rub, this guy, 441 South. Fat Henry's classic rub. I use it on just about all the beef that I cook. It's really good. Some people just use salt and pepper on steak. That's fine. That's really good. I like this on steak, though. Here's our steak. So we got a certified Angus beef choice cowboy steak. Certified Angus beef claims that their choice is like a USDA prime. And this is all that Patton sells. So it's all certified Angus stuff, and it always turns out really good. And I've kind of, I've had this out for about an hour. Try to bring it up to room temperature. It's not quite there yet, but we'll go ahead and cook it. This is nerdy, but I picked this one because, so this muscle right here is called the spinalis. It's like the best part of any steak you can ever eat, in my opinion. I love it. It's the best part. This is the best couple of bites right here. So I picked one that had a big spinalis on it.
And we should say that this is the nice thing about going to a like craft butcher shop as opposed to maybe your just local grocery store, right?
Oh yeah, big time. Yeah, they'll talk to me for a long time, helping me figure out exactly what to look for in a piece of meat. All right, so now we're just gonna rub it down. So I'm not gonna use too much of this stuff, but we're gonna, this helps get a really good crust on it. There's some coffee in this rub too. There's always just a really good dark crust on the outside of a steak when I'm done with it. So we'll just put a little bit on here. So now it's just time to put it on. All right, so we're on the big green egg. So this is indirect cooking. So I have the plate setter in so that the heat's coming around it, but not directly under it. And we'll just shut it and leave it for, we'll check it again in about 20 minutes and see where our temp's at. Okay, so you can tell that it's almost rare when you can start to hear like drippings. What a dumb thing to say. I'm not gonna say that anymore.
What Adam's trying to say is you can tell when the steak is coming up to a medium rare, a...
Who knows?
What?
Who could tell?
You know what?
You can tell it's almost time to sear it when you hear stuff dripping down in
yeah,
there.
Yeah, it's fine. Don't worry about it.
The ultimate point is that everything's just fine. Just everybody calm down. It's fine. I have learned that when this says 275, the grate where the meat is typically about 25 degrees less than this says.
So you have dome temp.
Dome grate. Temp and grate temp. The weird thing is there's an exchange at some point where the dome temp goes down and the grate temp goes up. I don't know why. It just always happens. It's a mystery. If you know why, comment below. Okay, so this is important too. I have not flipped the steak because it's indirect heat, so there's no need to flip it. You just leave it. So I'm gonna probe it again. I think we're just about, that's 119, right in the middle of it.
All right.
This is rare right now, and my thought is when we're done searing it, it'll be a good medium rare.
Great.
We just wanted to get really hot, so I'm gonna wait until this thing starts to flame up. I'm just gonna put the grates right over the coals now, so we're gonna be direct now. Well, kinda. I'm putting a cast iron skillet on top of these. So we're gonna sear it in a skillet because it's an awesome crust on the outside of it when you sear it in a cast iron skillet. And we're gonna use some bacon and butter. So we're gonna put some fat in there to help sear it up.
Do you know what it's called when you develop a crust on food?
No.
Scientific definition, scientific term.
What's that?
It's the Maillard reaction.
No.
Yeah.
Is it really?
Yeah, it's called the Maillard reaction. And it happens on, like, when you sear steak or chicken or fish, but also when you sear, like, vegetables, that sort of burned crust that happens on the outside that's really flavorful.
Yeah.
Maillard reaction.
Maillard.
Same thing happens when you roast coffee.
Really?
And when they char the inside of whiskey barrels. It's the same thing.
Really?
Yeah, Maillard reaction.
Drop some science on us. All right, so now it's time to sear. So, whoa, it's really hot.
That's
you're
the
supposed
idea,
to not do that. You're supposed to burp it, is what they say. So do this a couple times.
Oh, wait. So I didn't know that. Why do you burp it?
Because if you just open it, you'll, like, singe your hair off. So this kind of just lets some of the heat out, so you're not going to blast yourself away when you open it. All right, so we did that a few times. So I'm going to drop a piece of bacon in there.
Yes.
Give us a little fat. No, we're just going to use the bacon, and we're going to use butter. So, ready?
Yes. Look at that crust.
All right, so we just seared it. We got a great crust on the outside of it. So now we just want to cover it in aluminum foil for a few minutes and let it rest so that the juices can lock in. All right, so it's done. We let it rest. So let's see how it looks. We'll slice it up. So I'm gonna grab the bone right here. Slice this off real quick. All right, so there's the bone.
Wow.
And then we will just slice it like that. All right, so now we're ready to try it out. So here we go.
Oh.
It's good, right?
I've definitely paid for worse. Yeah, the crust is, like, really perfect.
Reverse sear. That's how you do it.
One of the best steaks I've legitimately ever had.
Nice.
Like, all joking aside, this is, yeah.
Good. It tastes amazing.
There you go. That is how you reverse sear a steak on a Big Green Egg. If you like what you saw, don't forget to like and comment under this video, and if you haven't done so already, be sure to subscribe here to our Eat Stuff YouTube channel. Barbecuing, slow cooking, searing, doing everything on a Big Green Egg. So yeah.
Yeah, so Owen always, when he sees me out here, he's like, Daddy grilling the meat. Daddy's grilling the meat.
Coming to a t-shirt near you soon.
You just want me to say it?
Yeah, just be cool.
Daddy's grilling. That's going to be hard to say with a straight face.